That's unfortunate.
So we didn't get any of that.
I didn't know. You didn't get me saying f***.
Now I have to explain again that you weren't really saying that and that we're going to beep you out.
Why would you explain that?
Because I feel bad that you dropped the bomb.
Why? Well, I'll bet Terry Gross does it all the time.
My money is on she does not.
Oh, you never know what's happening on that ISDN in the raw track. I'll bet Terry Gross swears like a sailor.
Terry Gross, if you would like to weigh in and let us know which one of us is right, hashtag Terry Gross don't drop no F-bomb.
You know, I'll bet she's shut in. She needs things to do. I'll bet we'll hear from her.
We would love to hear from you, Terry Gross.
Or anyone else, for that matter. Just go to CoupleCo.com. There's a contact form. Welcome to Couple Co., working with your spouse for fun and profit. I'm Blaine Parker.
Which makes me Honey Parker.
Now, if you are a regular listener to Couple Co., you know that we are temporarily adapting for the weirdness of our times.
Our regular interviews of inspiring couples in business together are on hold.
They are on hold. Instead, we are bringing you special pandemic editions of Couple Co., the Mayhem Marketing Minute.
You're very happy about Mayhem.
Here's the new music. Oh, yeah, it's got a little mayhem, but it's upbeat and you can dance to it.
It's getting stuff done music.
Getting stuff done music. Okay, now, our refrain for the pandemic craziness has been asking, what does my customer need right now, and how can my business adapt right now to serve that need?
In this episode, we're continuing on that theme with one of our favorite CoupleCo interviewees.
Dave Lakhani and Sarah Skeem are partners in Growth Foundry, a digital marketing agency based in Boise, Idaho.
We interviewed them back in episodes 88 and 89.
Yeah, and it was a good interview.
Very good.
Dave is a marketing powerhouse and an internationally known persuasion expert. He was also the first person ever to put Honey and me on a stage to speak about branding, and it was nothing but uphill from there.
We've been a juggernaut.
Yes, totally, until we decided we were tired of juggernauting and...
Well, emphasis on not.
Started doing this. But who knows? With all the weirdness, maybe we can start speaking on stages again with nobody in the room.
Well, it's easier to get up with no one there.
Yeah. Anyway, we were able to catch up with Dave in Boise right before he hit the road. Who knows where he was going? There's a pandemic.
We asked him if you could provide a marketing tip for a business looking to survive the mayhem. What would it be?
His answer was in-depth and was interesting.
As everything from David.
Well, yeah. I mean, not only is a persuasion expert, but go listen to episode 88. He talks about his background growing up in a cult and leaving at age 16. You are going to hear a few audio glitches where Dave's internet audio is being uncooperative. So know that it's not you, it's us.
You sounded like a bad date. It's not you, it's me.
Great. Welcome to CoupleCo Bad Date Minute. Here now, Dave Lakhani and his mayhem marketing tip, which is predicated on a theme of opportunity through service.
If you are a non-essential business, as it's being described today, which is, you know, basically grocery stores and medical facilities, pharmacies, those kinds of things that people have to function on a daily basis, and you're being required to, you know, send employees home and all of those things, then, you know, the thing that I say is start questioning how you can continue to deliver whatever products you sell, particularly if you're brick and mortar based. So how do you deliver to people, or how do you process orders by phone and then ship them to people, mail them, or do whatever? As people are shifting to Amazon to buy more and more, or online generally, but especially Amazon, I think it's an opportunity for brick and mortar stores to say, how might we also deliver what we have to our loyal client base and make it just as easy as buying from Amazon?
Ooh, that's a good one.
Yeah. One of the clients that we have is a local spa, and she had to close her doors for 30 days. But what it really means is people just can't come in. It doesn't mean that she can't continue to sell. So she's doing things like offering people an opportunity to call her up with the order for the products that they normally need, you know, because she sells things like hair care and all of that. So they can call and she will, free of charge, ship them the products. So she just charges their credit card over the phone, ships them the products. And she doesn't have an e-commerce site, by the way. So it's not like she's like scrambling to replace everything. She's just saying, look, how could I do this? I can do it by phone. That technology exists. It's easy and people can use it while they're stuck at home.
it's interesting. One of the things that we've been saying is a good question to ask yourself right now is, what does my customer need right now, and how can I adapt right now to meet that need?
Exactly. And so one of the another client that we have is a sleep center in Tennessee, and they are making an opportunity right now using the recent changes in telemedicine and technology to actually do at-home sleep apnea testing. So they've switched completely from come into the lab, spend the night in the lab, to listen, we're going to send you a single-use sleep apnea testing device. It's called the WatchPat. You wear it on your wrist at night, and with a couple of other small pieces of tubing that you use, and they can do complete sleep apnea testing, interpret the results the next morning, have them have a, you know, a consultation with a sleep apnea specialist, and then actually prescribe and deliver CPAP if it's needed, all of this within 7 days. Traditionally, it takes weeks to months to get into a sleep lab, and then another few weeks after that to get your equipment and everything else. They've now used this opportunity, you know, in combination with telemedicine, to be able to reduce that delivery time to 7 days, which is amazing. And I think we'll see many of these opportunities come up. So I think when you look at it, it's like really thinking about, how do I deliver the service that I've traditionally delivered in the confines of four walls, from a remote location, to people who are also having the same restriction of needing to be inside of the four walls that they generally are not driving to on a daily basis. So they're stuck at home. And so how do they get the services and the goods that they need from their local purveyors without having to fundamentally change what they do? Or in fact, may even become easier, like in the case of sleep apnea testing, where, you know, they're able to get that testing right in the convenience of their own home, literally in their own bed.
You said something that I don't know that everybody's thinking right now, and it's a great thing, and that's, you dropped the word opportunity. We all know that this is a challenge, and it's weird, and it's a struggle, or whatever the heck we want to call it, but it's also a marathon, and if you see something as an opportunity, you might actually win the race.
That's right. And I think that the mistake that people will make, there's this instant panic, right? And I totally understand it when it comes to, you know, restaurants and bars and people like that who have a high level of, you know, hourly workers, and they're highly dependent on a high level of traffic that turns very quickly. You know, it's high volume business. Like, those people, without question, are going to be impacted. But if they haven't yet embraced Uber Eats, for example, or DoorDash, or one of those kinds of services, they're just really not thinking of the opportunity. If you're the local delivery person, we have a place here called Hot Shots that delivers in Boise, where I live. And, you know, if I were a local organization or a local company, I would be looking to those people and saying, between those and the taxi drivers, how am I able to, you know, in a no contact way, be able to deliver my products and services there? So for restaurants and people like that who are laying off those hourly workers, they could look at it and say, okay, what is the skeleton crew we can work with? And how do we, again, adjust and say, okay, it's time to use Uber Eats, or if I can't use Uber Eats, then use the local taxi service to serve my populace.
Or perhaps these workers that you may not be able to keep on in your schedule could become drivers for the moment.
Absolutely. I do think this will fundamentally change how business is done once it's over. You know, and if you're an online business, the opportunity is also very high. So if you've been embracing or thinking of embracing things like online lead generation with Facebook or Google, like, those prices are rapidly changing and fluctuating because people are pulling back on their ad budgets when they should be doubling down.
You clearly heard our last episode.
Right. And, you know, when that opportunity exists to buy traffic at lower cost than you normally would, you should take advantage of it. And you should also look at, who are markets that are suddenly not served that you could serve based on the fact that people are closing down. That's a small cough from allergies, not that I just spread coronavirus through the wonders of technology.
Well, thank you for clarifying. I was really worried for just a moment.
Yeah, it's the most frightening thing in the world now. God, you're afraid to cough or sneeze anywhere.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
So going back to it, where do you find these opportunities to serve people that are not being served now in a traditional format using this new tool? So going back to the sleep center, the cloud-based ability to get sleep results directly from a device on someone's arm into a technician's hand overnight changes things. The expansion of telemedicine capability under some of the law changes now offers them the opportunity, without going and getting a bunch of people relicensed in other states, to be able to deliver that service through telemedicine to neighboring states. So now they're able to serve Tennessee and now Georgia, and that will continue to expand. So I think we're really seeing these great opportunities on the back end of this for companies, I would say. You know, another real opportunity is that as people begin to recognize where our critical supplies and products are manufactured, there's going to be a big push of building those infrastructures and manufacturing capabilities back in the United States. So there's going to be a giant opportunity for entrepreneurs and certainly for marketers to be able to take advantage of this as we get through it.
You know, I also think to that point, we first talked about what can you do right now to serve your customer and give them what they need, but also with an eye to the future, what is your business going to look like? And if you have lower traffic right now in your business, if you're not as busy as you were, can you use this time to build something that is going to be really valuable when all of this nuttiness is over?
Absolutely. And also just really evaluating how you deliver your business. You know, I think what people are starting to realize is the truth about how many of those meetings that they've held in person, you know, could have been done via email or Zoom. You know, like they're suddenly realizing all this time that we waste on a daily basis could be put to a much better use, because that meeting that we just had really could have been handled by an email, because look, we just did it for 2 weeks.
I think it's going to be very interesting to see what happens to the college and university model.
Completely. Couldn't agree more with you, honey. I think that as you look at this and we start to see that, you know, education can be adequately delivered via technology right to someone's home, you know, especially at the college level, there it really becomes a hard argument to say that my degree is now worth $70,000 a year.
Yeah.
And it also says, if I can learn directly from my computer at home, why wouldn't I learn from the very best instructor in the world on this topic? Not the 500th best, but the number one or two best. And if you're Harvard or Stanford or Yale or one of those places, why wouldn't you deliver the very best education you can? I think the economics of college will change. And then, you know, we have another client in Canada who does heavy equipment training. So they do everything from like front end loaders and graders and all, you know, gravel road maintenance, all of these kinds of things, a majority of which is done in a classroom. Some of it has practical as well. They primarily focus on safety or road improvement and those kinds of things. So a lot of it is done in classroom. And they were able to immediately switch to a model of doing live training via Zoom. And also they had been proactive. They'd been putting a lot of their stuff on video to put it online. So they were able to shift models almost at the push of a button to be able to deliver education in that way. So I completely agree with you, honey. I think that education fundamentally will be forever changed as a result of this.
Yeah, my aunt just asked me yesterday if I had ever heard of Zoom. You know, it's technology is permeating all levels.
I was going to say, Dave, if you could give somebody one action item to take away from this, what would it be?
Right now it would be to take a look at all of your opportunities that exist because of what's happening now. Where can you serve people that haven't been or aren't being served with the products or services that you offer? And look at how you can use the current gaps in marketing that are starting to exist online or offline to be able to reach out to those people and offer it to them. Everybody is sitting in front of their cell phones now and they're answering calls and they're taking calls. If I owned a brick and mortar business or any other business, I would be picking up the phone and calling people just to check in on my customers and let them know what I'm doing.
That's excellent. I love that one.
Dave, thank you very much for doing this.
This was quite an opportunity.
It was an opportunity.
Thanks very much for having me. I appreciate it. And I hope that everyone listening to this is well and finding a million opportunities to grow during this time.
A million opportunities.
Excellent. But just work on one.
Indeed.
So, take a look at the opportunities that exist because of what's happening now.
How can you serve people who aren't being served?
And how can you make use of the gaps? If you'd like to learn more about Dave Lakhani You can find him online at boldapproach.com. That's boldapproach.com.
If you have any questions for us during this
weirdness,
okay, weirdness.
Pick one.
You can reach out to CoupleCo on Facebook at CoupleCo Podcast.
And we will see you on the next Mayhem Marketing Minute from CoupleCo, working with your spouse for fun and profit.
CoupleCo is a production of Slow Burn Marketing LLC, copyright 2020, all rights reserved.
Love you, baby.
Love you, too.
CoupleCo out.